Before we continue...
Come on then, laddie!
Show me your strength!
Can you you tell which is which?
Oh, yes. Wonderful. I couldn't have beaten him more soundly myself. I must say, I doubted you had it in you. But you have proved me wrong. And for once, that is no bad thing. The power of the technique comes from your heart. Hone that greatest of weapons, and none will be able to stand before you. Now, I think it's time we peeled that old degenerate off the flagstones, don't you?
You beat me, even with the last secret of Angrila in my side. Oh, I can't believe how much you've grown, laddie.
You weren't too much of an embarrassment, no. Perhaps I finally have a disciple worthy of the name.
So this is where you have been hiding.
Wait, I know that voice.
Mordigan.
Sniveling worms. You thought to escape my clutches by cowering here in this ruined world. You have only delayed the inevitable.
No! Curse you! I had thought your powers could not reach us here! It seems I underestimated you. So inconsiderate. There was one last thing I wanted to teach you. Fine. It seems we must do it the hard way. You two will just have to learn the ultimate ability here and now. Or die trying.
What? So the last secret of Angrila wasn't the last one? And Quadra Slash wasn't either?
Of course not, foolish man. There is another. A supreme skill devised by Grandmaster Ayi. One that Erdwin and Morkan performed together. Well, don't just stand there! Combine your powers. Revive the technique that was lost to us so long ago. So that I can die happy.
You dare to resist me?
You must do exactly as I say. Exactly when I say it. We have only one chance. Robert, do not think. Act. Use the technique I taught you. Quickly! Unleash Quadra Slash! Yes, the last and greatest of all the secrets of Anguilla. The technique to end all techniques. Solar flare!
He is back with us. But he is greatly weakened. We must get him to the temple right away.
Ah, you are finally awake. Good. I feared you had suffered some lasting injury. Lord Robert awoke a short while ago. He's outside speaking with the High Lama. We should join them.
Hello there, laddie. Better late than never, eh? What are you staring at me like that for? Is there something on my face?
It is your physique, Lord Robert. You were a good deal slighter only a short time ago.
Oh, that! Nothing a good breakfast couldn't cure. Aye, the Grand Master put me through worse on more than one occasion.
Lord Robert has told me what came to pass in the Void, that you met Grand Master Pang, and that she trained you in the ancient arts. I hear that you were even able to master the ultimate abilities of your ancestor Erdwin. You have my congratulations.
And I hear that I owe you a debt of thanks, Sir Henrik, for looking after the boy here while I was away.
Please think nothing of it, my lord. It is the least I could do to make amends for all the wrongs I have done. Indeed, I feel I must apologize.
Ach, don't torture yourself over it, son. We've all been pawns in Mordigan's game. You've nothing to apologize for.
Thank you.
Truly.
What do you intend to do now? We had hoped to find guidance here in Angrila, but alas, we find ourselves at an impasse.
Well, funnily enough, I was just thinking about something Grandmaster Pang told me. She said old Erdwin used a very special form of transport when he went after the Dark One. Some sort of sacred flying contraption.
Whatever could that mean?
I didn't get the chance to ask her any more about it. But it sounds like just what we need to get up to that castle and knock Mordigan off his perch. As for our old friends, none of them were exactly the giving up type, eh? If I'm still alive and kicking, you can bet the rest of them are out there somewhere. So, what say we head over to Arboria and keep an eye out for our pals on the way? If this flying doodad's supposed to be sacred, the folks over there'll know something about it for sure. There's no time to lose. The longer we wait, the stronger Mordigan gets. So, let's get going.
Disciples of Angrila will do all that we can to aid you in your preparations to take on the Lord of Shadows. We have even devised a special training regime for you. Visit us again soon. We will stand ready to help you hone your powers.
That man is in danger. We must go to his aid.
Oh, no, you don't, honey. Not unless you want to carry those claws home in a bag.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Silvando, darling, you were fabulous. So fierce.
Fierce doesn't even begin to describe it. You were ferocious.
Can it be? Can it truly, truly be? Truly, truly, truly? It is. I think it really is. Darling, it's so wonderful to see you. I thought you were lost to me forever.
You two are acquainted? And what is it that you do, exactly?
Oh, come now. Isn't it obvious? We're fighting an epic battle to bring back something the world has lost. That's right, darlings. We're on a quest to bring sunshine and laughter back to every corner of this drab, drab world. My little parade has picked up quite the cavalcade of warriors for wondrousness. Aren't they just so much fun? But never mind that now. I can't believe you're alive. It's a miracle. I thought I'd never see you again. Excuse me? Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. I forgot all about you. Are you okay? You're not hurt, are you?
No, I am not. Thanks to you. You are more strong than you appear. My name is Dar. I come from Phenomenon in the south. And if it were not for your help, I would not be returning there. Thank you.
You're heading home. Then we better go with you. Can't have you getting attacked again now, can we, Listen, darling, you and me have got a lot to talk about. So what do you say you join the parade for a little while, huh? Come on. You know you want to. Oh, did he really just... So cold. But you don't need to be shy, darling. I know you're just itching to join me and the boys, really. Okay, time for you to take your first steps as a soldier of the smile-spreading special forces. Here, put these on. No? You look even more adorable than I thought you would. So proud. All right, boys, let's make our newest recruit feel right at home. He's an old friend of mine, after all. Lead on, darling! And don't let me cut you frowning. You're at the head of the world's premier gladness-bringing parade! All right, let's get out there and make the world smile! And shimmy!
And here we are at our destination, the beautiful, bustling tourist town of Phnom Non.
Not here, too. The whole world is just so dreary these days.
Thank you for saving me. I must go now.
I wonder what can have made him venture so far from home in the first place. Might it have something to do with why the town is so quiet?
Sounds like a job for Sylph's detective agency. Leave this to me. Agents of happiness, soldiers of smile, go spread some special parade cheer and find out what's going on around here. Let's go to work.
Why can I not shake the feeling that Silvando and I have met somewhere before?
Thank you. Da, you are okay. You are not hurt. Oh, what a relief. I was fearing the worst for you, especially after little son has gone missing, you know.
Your boy is missing? Oh, honey.
Ugh. Where that selfish child chooses to go is none of my concern.
You must forgive him. His wife died recently, you know, and now his son has gone missing. It is very hard for him. Do you know of the monster Avarith? She appeared in the village with her foul friends soon after Yggdrasil fell and the darkness came. We were paralyzed with fear and could not run away. Then she gathered us all in the square. Give me your valuables, she said. Tell me what is most precious to you. I will protect it. People were so scared, they obeyed her without thinking. They gave her money, husbands, wives, even children. But the wicked creature lied to us. She did not protect the things we gave to her. No, she took them and ran away.
Oh, that's just awful.
Oh, if there's one thing I hate, it's dirty, rotten liars. Don't worry, honey. We're gonna get all your stuff back. All of it.
Really? But Avarith is very strong, very powerful.
Oh, it'll take more than a common thief to stop me. I won't let you down. You know what they say, a knight's word is his bond.
A knight?
Avarith went south with everything she stole. She has a lair there, I think.
Then let's get after her. We've got an evildoer to punish.